Hello guys, and welcome back to Missouri River Bottoms in FS19 on PC. And if you want to be part of my farming simulator series, just subscribe to my channel. And then if you're liking the video as well, hit that like button so you can help out the videos to grow more. Here I'm standing in the front of the HUDDIG tractor, and this is the 1260E city version. It is one of the newest mods I have in the game, and I have actually tried out to mow some grass. Just some small areas, and it actually works very well. But now we will just jump on this motorcycle here, the IZH Planet 5K, and we are going over to one of my fields, and we will continue to do some work. And also, I hope you all are doing well out there in the world. My little garage. And to the right, you can see my home for now, the tent. And if you speed up a little bit, you can see my rabbit shelters, which are giving me some money, some income. And up there, what do you think that is? Yeah, it is a building, but what kind of a building? I will show you that later. In the back you can see my one of my sheds and the Swedish flag. And I think up here I have my car as well. So just stop here for now and go out to the Valtra, the older version. So I'll stop the motorcycle here. We jump off. Here I got my Chevy Silverado 2020. And here we have a deer tractor, the 8530. And in the back here we got this. Yeah, the John Deere 2623 disc plow. Another Valtra tractor. I think this is the S series. Yeah, S394 version. And we also got the cedar here, the Amazon. A little bit dirty, but yeah. So let's get to work and we will do some cultivating, continue with that. And we will work with this, the Sapphire, and this Valtra 8950 plus version. And also I will show you the map and what we have to do. As you can see, we need to cultivate this field number 67. And then we also need to, let's see, no, I don't think we can also plow it up if we want to do that. So first of all, we unfold the cultivator. And we lower it to the ground. And we get to work. It's almost lunchtime here in the game. And the real clock is 10 o'clock. So yeah, some difference. Weather is okay. And we'll just do some of the work here on the field today. Quite dirty inside, I can't see much. No, I mean outside. And I can't see a damn thing, so I need to use this third person view. Also, I'm going to share in my description some other links to other players, so you can see what maps they are playing on and what they are doing on their farm. Missouri River Bottoms. Yeah, I have a few. One day ago or 2 days ago, I had some burglars here, and they were. Was setting up a fire on a few houses, burned down to the ground, but I know that I have the police still standing in the area to surveillance. But for now I don't care about that, I'm just keep doing my work on my fields, because it is that I need to focus on, so I can after that start to produce. I'm going to show you the olive oil factory. So I'm going to produce olive oil, and I think maybe some jam or marmalade as well. But we still need to do this farmer's job to keep his field in position and running, make income on that as well. That you should know. I'm not doing anything in time lapse as well. I'm just going for real time work. So I think after this lap, when we go back where we started, I will pull out my deer tractor to the field and set that in plowing precision. Maybe I will work with that tractor as well. We just turn around here and sliding a little bit in the field, but Valtra is handling this cultivator quite good. So that is the work we're going to do today. Maybe I will also show you the mower on the HUDDIG 12,000 version of that, the city tractor. I also need to get we are back. Just got some trouble with my cables here on my computer because of my little cat. But now we are back again. So I have not bought any silos or something like that yet, but I think we need to buy something to store our grains and our crops and everything after the harvest. I will also start to buy some other equipments that we are going to need further in the series and in the future. So that's how it is for now. Now I have to see how we are going to do this, because now I have the John Deere in front of me. I think I will try to steer right here without crashing into it. And then we lift up the cultivator, we back up a bit so we actually can continue, and we lower the cultivator again. I think this will go. That went all good. Now I will just go straight over. And then here I will just turn around and go back, because after that I will pull out the John Deere into the field, and I will then put the helper on so I can get some help with plowing up the ground. Meanwhile, I am doing this cultivating job, because, as you can see, I don't have such much money. 86,000, so, but we can use it for a bit. I will try that out, if that can be to any help for me. So turn around here. Oh, we missed that little spot there, so we just back up. Cultivate that, turn around here. So now you can see we have some space here now. So I will leave the tractor running. The engine is still on. We go over to the deer here. And we jump into that. The engine is on, we connect to the disc in the back, we unfold that. It's quite a big one, so we need to see if we need to change angle. We lower it into the ground. And we go forward. We jump over. And get into the tractor again. I think I will go a little bit faster than the deer, but we will see. Now we race. Without crashing into each other. Because I will turn around here. And the deer needs a little bit more time to actually turn the tractor around. And you will see that when I get up to the end here. You can see who's leading and why I'm turning around and why the deer doesn't. So once again, a little bit of rush here. See there, I'm just stop there and get into the field again. I'm not lifting up the what is that tractor doing all the way up there? That is actually not good for now. How is that even possible? Okay, we just jump in here. See if we can do anything here. Crazy shit. That is not good, so. I would actually just drive back full speed. What was that all about? And as you can understand now, I will not use the helper anymore. So now we will have to do one thing. I will shut the tractor off. I will go into landscaping tool. Because we need to fix this. You can see. We hit X and then we change ground type very quickly to grass. Make the circle bigger. And then we put grass back. That was very actually strange. How is that even possible? So you see now, we're just putting grass back here. So we are then done with that. Go out and jump back into the Valtra. And I will then continue to cultivate up the ground. I do like the sound of the Valtra. This older sound of tractors. I like that more and then newer. Also, I like older equipments to use on the fields and everything I do. But that's my thing. And that is also interesting to me to know what you are using. What kind of equipments and what you are doing on your farms. Just leave a comment in the comment section what equipment you are using and what you are like most in farms in to do. So this field here number 66 is the grass field here. We're going to mow up all the grass there and turn that, and after that maybe we will try to build something. Maybe build a hay house or grass house with bales, with square bales, maybe. All rounded, we will try something out. Missouri River Bottoms. This is a nice map. But as you can see, I'm only into day 2. And it takes some time to do this kinds of stuff when you're playing all by yourself. And that you should be aware of that. So you can say that this is real time. Real time in real life farming simulator. 2019 on PC. And also in my description you will find some links to where you can get the mods. Example on fs19.net or maybe on ModHub or Mod Network. You can download very kinds of different mods that you can use in the game. So I really do that you enjoy this video. So we just go straight, then we lift up the cultivator, turn around. Lower it to the ground, continue moving forward over and over again. So this will be a quite shorter video. So before we stop this recording, we will use the HUDDIG tractor and we will mow some stuff around this field here to the left, for example. So we can make the remove those bushes here and make it cleaner and make it nicer around it, because I will I'm going to place down some fence around the field too as well, so the animals can't go in and eat up our crops. And my next video will be a different one, and maybe from a different game as well, which I bought 2 days ago, and the game is called Snow Runner. Difficult game, but still fun. I will show you that in my next video, what to do and so on. So some weed are coming up from the ground, we need to remove that too as well. We don't have so much to cultivate left here on the field. Few laps left. And I still got the a lot of AdBlue left in my tank, and fuel I have quite much too, so I think I can finally do this cultivating job without refueling the tank. Now you maybe understand why I need to put some fence around the field, because when you saw the John Deere just going crazy, I realized that I need to put some fence around and it will stop. Oh, there we remove some weeds. So this will be our last lap, and we will change. Then we will take the car or maybe the motorcycle back to the farm and jump into the other tractor and start to mow some grass. And I will show you how it works a little bit more. You can hear the birds flying all around me. Quite nice to having them here. Yeah. So I don't have any money yet to buy any house or something, so I still live in the tent. So I need to get something to eat before we continue to work with the tractor around the feel here. Yeah, that's how it is. So I will see you get back by the HUDDIG tractor when I have finished this job. See you soon. So I have just getting into some new troubles or thoughts that I realized that, okay, I will, what do I want to use when I'm going back? Well, we take the car for now. We take the Chevy. Chevy stock. Actually, a nice Silverado that we have here. Now we are going to turn around here without doing anything stupid. So we just turning around here. Smoothly here. You can hear the turbo, but now we are going back to our main farm. We're going to change tractor and do some other work. And then I will see if I have any food in my tent. Otherwise, I don't know what I'm going to do, but I will stop here first. I'll just have a look here if we have something to eat. No fire. I have the grill here, but I don't think I have any food here. No, nothing in that bag. Back to the car. Well, all right. I will eat quite soon. But for now, I will. I'm going to work with the tractor now. I'll try to just stop here. Down there, we have another Valtra tractor, but a smaller one that we use on the field. And in here, just got some other stuff, forage machine. Nice one, T-Rex 600, and then a bucket for the HUDDIG tractor and one bucket for the back arm on it. So now, my dear friends and fans, we are going to try this machine out. And okay. This is the interior. A lot of things you can actually do. But now we will. Lights on and we will. And it's running and we have the lights on. And now we have to check. Why is what side? We'll just flip over. Okay, we change back. The button doesn't. And now. Well, all right. Okay, we change group. That is the. Yeah, there we are. You can see the arm is moving. And from the outside, lift up the HUDDIG again. We will now figure out and zero. Now we can turn the mower on. There, we can hear the sound of it. And that is the axle. This is just a camera. I zoom out. So then we lower that one, so we push on button G to select tool. Okay, this is group number two. Okay. I need to lower the mower. Okay, that is left and this is right. And if we hold in the backhoe, and that is that one. Alright. And then selection number group number three. What's that? That is the, I think the windows and the doors and the right is the top and both is the, now I see. I need to raise. That up so we can go forward. All right. So we change group again, group number three, yeah, easier to move around the axle when you are driving. So for now I'm just showing you how this tractor works, and if you're not into working with these kinds of tractors, you just need to try and work with them. And from the inside view it looks like this. And now we will try to remove some of the bushels here. It doesn't go away. Alright. But the grass is going away. So that is our here that we want to try out to do. So for now we're just trying this out and see how it works. But as you can see, we are moving in 7 kilometers per hour, which is not fast enough. We're doing this job quite fast, so there is one problem. So from the inside view it looks like this. You can see the mower to the right here. So I think we need to buy another mower so we can remove some of the bushels we have in the side to the right and up by our field as well, because it doesn't look any nice or any good. So right now we are just trying this out and how is working. And I think I will buy a mower to my John Deere, the 8530 tractor. Nope, not that one. Moving a little bit more into the middle here. So and then we bring it back into the section. Then you can stop and then move it like this. Quite difficult. But now we reach the end. I need to go and move the motorcycle here. So look at this now when I'm backing up. And then we just park. Just park it here for now. And then we jump back into the red one. City HUDDIG tractor again. 1260E. And we continue. And then I think we will stop somewhere here. I can go a little bit more further. I will stop there. Turn back, turn on the front tire. So now we have find the HUDDIG tractor out a bit, and we are now going to mow around our house down here. Yeah. Start the mower up, and now I will do a special I will actually go I would actually back up with the tractor here. Just use a different way. We'll see. It's different and this is tough to... We just do something like that. We jump inside, then we can change and then... do like this to remove this grass here. Can't see them thing. Yeah, something like that. And we even move a little bit of this. I might be thinking going in here. And that is going all right. Back up, I have to back up a little bit here. So we... can get everything with us. And then we go forward again. And we are actually... done soon with this. It's actually quite tough to do. Let's go forward here. Straight over. And then back. And then up. And then turn around. See? Easy. Easy wheezy. But it's still difficult to move this mower. Not perfect, but it's still tough to do. But I think we are... then we can lower it a little bit more. Because of the ground type. The ground is... moving up a bit here. Wheels are spinning. Okay. Now that should be done. So we just back up a little bit here. Yeah. And now we are done with the testing. So just leave the tractor here for today. Okay. And then I will run through here. Jump back into the core. We are now going to drive back out to the field again and continue to work with our ground and cultivate and plow up so we can do some other stuff. In my next video I will do some other kinds of stuff in Farm Sim, but I will still do some mowing and buy some other stuff. So I will just say thank you for being here with me today. I will leave some information in my description on what we have done today and so on. Okay guys, thank you for being here with me today. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you can follow me and follow the game Farming Simulator 2019 to be a bigger game online, and also like the video as well. Okay guys, thank you and have a nice day. Bye bye.